So life evolved here on Earth, and it may have been that circumstances for the evolution of life are not unique to Earth, that just a certain range of geological processes, chemical processes, would allow life to originate in other planets as well. What do we know about life elsewhere? What do we know about other planets? Well, there's a very interesting find from Antarctica that was discovered about 10 or 15 years ago. On top of the snow and ice on the Antarctic continent, somebody found a small piece of rock, and it turns out that that small piece of rock came here from Mars. A meteor or an asteroid struck Mars at some point, blowing rocks out into space, and some of them landed here on Earth. And what's interesting about this particular specimen is that in flying through space and coming all the way to Earth, it would have been heated up, like shooting stars are, but not that hot. And so this particular stone at one edge got pretty hot, but the rest of it was never much hotter than about 40 degrees Celsius. Now that's a temperature that modern bacteria on Earth can easily cope with. So it's possible that with low temperature movement of material like this rock from Mars suggests that life could possibly travel through space, that live bacteria could possibly have gone from one planet to another. Now, Mars was covered with water right after its formation, and actually at an earlier stage than here on Earth. Our oceans took a lot longer to form because the Earth's surface was so hot. We were such a big planet, it took a long time to cool down. Mars, being smaller, cooled down more quickly. So the conditions of that primordial soup could have hit Mars a billion years earlier than it did here on Earth. And so we have various spaceships that are going to Mars. They're looking for the conditions of water and organic compounds that might appear on Mars. And there are various hints that there could be circumstances in the history of Mars that could have given rise to life. Now, samples that are being collected recently have not yet found anything compelling that life did actually evolve on Mars as well, but it's not impossible, at least not yet. The evidence is still out whether life could have also evolved on Mars, or there could have been movement of life between Mars and Earth. Some people even suggest that life originated on Mars and then was brought to Earth by one of those fragments of rock. So if we were to ever find some living organism on Mars, this would be the most amazing genetic study ever, because we want to know, where would Martian DNA fit onto our tree of life? So we have seen this many times, and this connects DNA similarities through these main categories of bacteria, these different domains, the bacteria and the archaebacteria and the eukaryotes. They all have a common ancestry. And if we could get Martian life, let's say there was bacteria on Mars as well, and we sequenced it, and we found absolutely no connection between those living things on Earth and those on Mars, that would suggest that life originated a second time on Mars. On the other hand, if we found there was enough similarity between Martian life and ours, assuming it exists, that would suggest there might have been contamination from Mars bringing life to Earth, or vice versa. Perhaps at some point an asteroid struck Earth after life had started here and went to Mars. Now, people are looking not just on Mars, but elsewhere. And a lot of astrophysicists are asking, could circumstances for the evolution of life exist elsewhere in the universe? And if you think about us in the big picture of the universe, we're a small dot. As viewed from the other sides of Saturn, we just look like a tiny particle in space. And if we turn our telescopes deep into space, we find, in fact, just 12 light years away is a star that's called Tau Ceti. And there is a planet that is just the right distance away from Tau Ceti that would keep temperatures within a range similar to that of Earth. It would neither be too hot for life to evolve or too cold. This particular planet happens to be 5 times more massive than Earth, so they'd have different kinds of gravity, but hey, the circumstances that could at least allow for the evolution of bacteria might exist there as well. So, to end this lecture, we've seen the origins of life, and those first living things are the bacteria. They are, in fact, the simple heroes of biology. They were the only life form on Earth for over 2 billion years. All the most important cellular processes having to do with replicating your nucleotide chain, your DNA, work perfectly well now in bacteria. Cell division, all of this is right there in these simple building blocks. And they're the most genetically diverse organisms alive on Earth today. They've had the longest time to diversify, and they are extraordinary in their diversity. And they gave rise to everything else. And as we see in the coming lectures, we'll start from bacteria and go through to multicellular organisms and ultimately end up with ourselves, human beings.